Professor Rahul Swarup Sharma. His areas of research are study of bulk nanomaterials through severe plastic deformation, multi-scale modeling, intelligent manufacturing, and soft computing. He has incorporated agility in forming industry, a novel design philosophy that is based on intelligent knowledge-based systems for enabling rapid design of existing production systems. The main outcomes of his research effort are development and implementation of efficient design methods for producing components by different metal forming processes. He has several ongoing research projects and also has authored several papers in refereed journals and has also co-authored a book. So, Professor Rahul Swarup Sharma.
Thank you very much, sir. So, this talk is quite different, the content that is already going into the school. So, it's severe plastic deformation, pushing the limits of strength. So, our idea is very simple, that we want novel materials for novel applications. So, the main criteria is to enhance the strength. And the second criteria is that it's a multiple objective problem, that is, we have to minimize the weight of the materials. So, it's a metal tetrahedron is there. If you want to enhance the performance, we have to change the properties. If you want to change the properties, we have to change the microstructure. And if you want to change the microstructure of a already naturally available material, we have to go for some enhanced processing techniques. So, there where we comes in. So our research comes into the novel processing techniques by which we can change the microstructure. If you are able to change the microstructure, definitely we will be able to change the properties and vis-a-vis the performance will be changed. So microstructure. So this can be done by main two approaches, either by top-down approaches or by bottom-up approach. So our work falls under the top-down approach, that we are taking a bulk material and we are trying to minimize the microstructure of the material. As I told you, if you are able to change the microstructure, we can enhance the properties. So what we are trying to do is that the severe plastic deformation, already many of our devices and in metal forming industries, we use plastic deformation. The problem with the plastic deformation is that change in shape takes place. So when the change in shape is taking place, so we have a limitation of applying the plastic deformation into the material. So here we comes into the severe, if we can severely deform the material by which we can change the microstructure. So SPT refined grains by introducing large number of dislocations that arranges themselves to produce ultra fine grains having high angle grain boundaries. So what we can achieve by severe plastic deformation is that plastic strain of the order of greater than 3, no dimensional changes, no fracture, no texture, new discipline of metal forming technology. But right now it is a batch process. And what we are aiming at DI is to develop a continuous process in which we can apply this severe plastic deformation. And this entire work is based on the Hall patch relationship, which states that if we are able to minimize the grain size, so there will be the increase in the yield stress. So advantages are, unlike powder metallurgy, no problems like in the bottom-up approach, no problems with the residual porosity after processing. SPD processed alloys have significantly enhanced properties, multiple passes through ECAP is possible, since no change in cross-section. Multiple passes are not possible in the normal plastic deformation techniques. And the most important things are that it can be conducted at a room temperature. And large bulk samples are possible, which are not possible into the bottom-up approach. So our work falls under this ultra-fine metals in the centers. In the conventional metal forming process, that is, we take coarse grain metal and we do traditional mechanism of plastic deformation. Intensive strain hardening is taking place. But as I said earlier, that shape change takes place. But in this case, we are doing little work hardening, but more strain is being introduced and we are able to reduce the microstructure without changing the shape of the samples. Best application of this particular material produced by this technique is that it can be used in medical implants. Because in medical implants, what we require, that is, weight has to be minimized. And the second thing is that strength has to be increased. So if you are able to use the metal which is being processed by SPD, so good amount of weight can be reduced. Second application is in the aerospace. So the idea is this, we are taking a coarse grain material and converting it into a smaller grain size. So this is what we are, our aim is, to reduce the grain size over the time without reducing the cross section. So these are some references by which it can be conveyed that UFG metal has got, ultra fine grain metal has got high yield strength as compared to coarse grain metals. As the grain size is reducing, hardness is increasing. These are all well established references just to convey that as the grain size is reduced, hardness is being increased. For this is for nickel, this is for copper. So this all data are. Now these are the different severe plastic deformation techniques. So this is a high pressure torsion. So in this case, what is being taken, only a coin size samples are being taken in this process, and high strain is being introduced. So what happens, the microstructure is changing, and the second thing is that no cross section is changing, but this particular technique is limited to small samples only. This is the working of this high pressure torsion. Then we have got one more technique, that is repetitive corrugation straightening. So this particular application is only possible for small sheet samples, where you are straightening, then again corrugated, then again straightening. So again, what is happening over the time, the microstructure is getting refined. Then we have got cyclic extrusion compression, then again very small samples, and the second is, it is a batch process. So grain size is refining when you are changing its deformation. Then we have got multi-axial forging, then again it's a clumsy process because multiple blows are required. So high pressure torsion already I discussed. Then we have got, for long samples, you can take accumulative roll balding, ARB technique developed in Japan. So over the time this, so but again it has got limitation, up to a certain limit only the deformation can be applied. Then it is a repetitive corrugation straightening, that means it has been enhanced to a continuous process. But again, sheet requirement is very less. I told you just in the medical implements, you don't require sheet. Even in aerospace application, you don't require sheets. Then this is constrained groove pressing, means the sample is being constrained from all the four sides. Then you are trying to apply deformation. By that, you are able to refine the grain size. So, but in this case, what happens, we don't get the uniform grain structure in the throughout the sample. So this was accumulated roll balding. So now comes the process on which we are working and most of the community is working, that is ECAP, equal channel angular pressing. So most of the disadvantage of earlier techniques that I have shown you, that in HPT small samples, in RCCS sheets can be taken, but in this case very high strain is being reduced in this area. You are putting one sample over here, coarse grained sample, and immediately you are pushing. So this is the only equal channel is there of the same size, and it is being pushed over this. So when it is taking a turn from this, so what is happening, there are good amount of change in microstructure is taking place, and second thing is that there is no change in the cross section. And this particular process can be repeated again and again because there is no change in cross section. So these are some formulations on which this particular process depends. So number of passes can be done. So again it has been refined, then this particular same billet is being taken, then again it is being further refined, then again this billet is taken, then again it is being further refined. So in this way, this can be done to an n number of times. So it has also got a limitation that reverse hole patch also starts after that. I'll show you the experiment that failure takes place. So the beauty of this technique is that the cross section remains same, and you are able to get in bulk samples in a good amount of billets of any diameter. Even for rectangular cross section also, these billets can be taken. But this particular process has not commercialized yet because there are a number of process parameters on which this particular shearing depends. So main parameters are what should be this angle and what should be this particular intersection angle. So this kind of study is being done at our institute in DI. And secondly, for different billet rotation is being done to get a uniform cross section. So root A, root B and root BC, if you want a proper So this has been, this billet is taken, then again it is being rotated by 90 degree, then again it is being put, rotated by 180 degree, then again it is being put, if you want to get a uniform cross section. So these are the dies that we have fabricated over here, and we are doing experiments here. So this is how this particular experiment takes place. So this is a concept that is being shown to, just to convince you, just by taking a normal plasticine and how the shearing is taking place and how the grain structure is being reduced over the time. So just showing, because in that case we cannot see what is happening into the, in this case, okay, what has, how much strain has been introduced in this, how much, so same images are there, I'll show you. So there are two aspects of this work. One aspect was this, okay, what should be the best process parameters. So for that we have done FEA modeling, good amount of FEA modeling for all different angles and all different process parameters like velocity, friction and temperature. So these are the results for which we have done. We are able to conclude something. So these are the results for different phi, different psi, friction and velocity. And for four passes we have done this. And these are the SP results for the copper. For two passes you can see E cap 2 passes, E cap 16 passes and E cap 16 passes with break pressure. And this was original specimen having a yield strength of 80 megapascal, and we were able to increase its yield stress by 440, 320, 420 and 440. Same was with the different parameters. But the problem is this, the technique is very good and it is well established, but it has not been commercialized till yet. The reason is this, till date, still it is the best process, because again and again that particular thing has to be done. So it is very difficult for a manufacturing industry, because good amount of time is required. So there has to be some technique by which we can make this process continuous. In one go you can achieve all five passes. So these are the some designs that we have devised over here, if we can do this particular or this. So in this case what is happening, two passes are being done. In this case three passes are being done. One turn is here, second turn is here and the third turn is here. So in one go you are achieving a strain rate of 3.45. In the single case we are achieving only strain rate of 1.15. So this particular aspect we are trying to design. So we have designed some new shapes. We have experimented. So these are the FEM simulations for different shapes and what is the forging force, what is the equivalent strain that is being generated. So again this particular shape, again we can send it from back and again we can get more strain is being induced. So in the literature till date people have worked with the 90 degree only. So we have tried the new set also that is less than 90 degree, that is 45, 65 and 75. In this case we are able, the results are very encouraging. I'll push up fast. So I'll show you, this is the first pass. The strain is being induced. The same billet is being repeated for the second pass. So the values are coming here, 1.75. In the second it was 3.58. In the third pass, the same billet is being put. We are getting a strain of 5.01. In the fourth one, we are getting 6.12. So this particular die shape is very encouraging. So for different degrees I am passing them 75.5. So the same study is being done. So this was, I was trying to show. So this particular slide shows a reverse Hall pressure. Means we cannot do for 5 passes or 8 passes, 10 passes. So this was the result that we achieved in the 6th pass. So in the 6th pass what was happening, this kind of failure was taking place. So this shows that after certain passes reverse Hall patch relationship exists. So same studies, so these are the same analysis results for 6082. So you can see for our samples only, this was a coarse grain metal, this was after first pass, this was after second pass, third pass and fourth pass. This can be seen how the grain size is being reduced after number of passes with this deformation. So we have done studies on copper also for different angles. These are the different angle dies. 150 degree is this, 105, 120. So, but the idea is to commercialize this technique. So, we have experimented with this two-turn die also, means one pass and second pass. But again, it is a batch process. But in this, the beauty of this process is that again, we can tilt the die, again, it can be done four passes more without taking out the billet. Again, we can start reversing it from here. So, again, it will go this side and again this way. So, four passes again you are getting just by tilting the die. So, these were the. So, this is the new thing that we are not going to publish. We are thinking for some patent. This is the three-turn die that we have developed over here. So, this is the complete assembly of this. So, the concept is this one. So, this die is being developed with a good amount of effort. So, it's a two-piece split die. So, one pass is going over here. Then, again, it is taking inside the second turn. Then, the third turn is being taken over here, this here. Then, coming out here. So, this has been done and experiments have gone successfully. So, this is the work that we have done at DIE. We have developed this particular die. So, the problem with this is this. We cannot put a single billet. We put first billet over here. When it reaches here, then we put second billet over here. Then the first one pushes it. Then again the third billet is being put when the third one reaches over here. So in this way at a time, four billets are always inside this. So this is the sample that we have received from, we have obtained from that particular. So it is not one piece. I have just joined it by some particular aspect. So this is one piece, one joint is over here. Okay, one joint is over here. So total four pieces are there. And further what we are developing is this, that a continuous EK process, I'll show it here. This is the novel that we have developed over here and the fabrication is in progress. Continuous EK process means if this particular kind of attachment is being attached to a rolling mill, so we can get nano samples, nano structured material in bulk form. So this particular setup is being attached to rolling mill. Normal rolls are coming over here. We are getting the normal rolls and now it is being passed in this way. So this was pass one. So strain was 2.4. Then again this is pass two. Equal strain is 4. Then again it is being pushed. But very high amount of forces are required. The problem is this. Very high amount of forces are required. And continuous process taking place. In the three-turn die, it was not a continuous process. It was a batch process putting the samples again in a discrete form. So this is the third pass. We are achieving a strain of 5.6. Now this is the pass 4. Syringe rate is 7.4. So commercial use of new knowledge, high strength, semi-finished products produced from EKF aluminum alloys have an application to manufacture following components. Fasteners used in the assembly of aluminum components for aircraft and other structures. Elements for aircraft fuselage assembly and section for geometry sheets for assemblies operating in corrosion at cryogenic temperatures and as well as biomedical implants. I will already show it to you. So conclusions are this, new discipline of metal forming technology means normal technique is only being used for reduce the microstructure. So for any questions, I'm thankful.